Dear learners, a very good day to all. As you know that the field of elementary education in our country has always been a prioritized sector, and this field of elementary education has given priority by all the governments of the at the central level as well as different state governments. As you also know that for achieving the target of universal elementary education in our country, a number of programs, a number of projects have been launched. And recently, the Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan and the Right to Education Act 2009, which came into existence on 1st April 2010, there was stress on involving community in elementary education affairs. This all was done to decentralize the management of elementary education and taking the elementary education decisions at the grassroots level. So for that, the community members or the local community organizations are involved in the field of elementary education. So today we are going to discuss about different management and governance issues which are faced by elementary education in our country. So learners, our main points of today's discussion will focus on the nature of management and governance in elementary education, major governance issues in elementary education, the governance issues related to students' admissions in elementary schools, the governance issues which are related to allocation and utilization of funds at elementary level, and the governance issues which are related to teachers' recruitment, teachers' promotion, and their regularity in elementary schools. And lastly, in this discussion, we are going to discuss about the governance issues which are related to functioning of SMCs in elementary schools. So this will be the broader framework of our today's discussion. So the focus of our today's discussion will orient around these main points. Now, first, the nature of management and governance in elementary education. As you can see on the screen, that the management and governance in elementary education is mostly decentralized in nature. Now, what we mean by decentralized management? Decentralized management means in which the involvement of all the stakeholders, right from the top level to the bottom level, are involved in the process of decision making. So the elementary education in our country follows a decentralized management structure. There is a management structure at the national level, then there is provision of management and governance at the state level, then at the district level, then at the block level, then at the cluster level, and then finally to the school level, which also includes the involvement of community members. So this, from the top level to the bottom level, indicates the decentralized management of elementary education in our country. Second feature of the governance in elementary education is the participatory planning. That means the planning in elementary education is done in a participative manner. The say, the views, the opinion of different stakeholders engaged in the elementary education activities or in the field of elementary education are considered while planning different activities. That means the micro planning activities, the community members are involved, the teachers are involved, and their inputs and feedback are taken while framing the overall policies. Then, in the field of elementary education, the emphasis is given on the local governance. Local governance means involvement of the community members, involvement of the parents, involvement of the Panchayati Raj institutions in the process of elementary education activities. So this is emphasis on local governance. Then in elementary education, different management structures have been created at various levels. At district level, for managing different activities of elementary education, DIETs have been established. DIETs, as you know, refer to District Institutes of Education and Training. Then to oversee the affairs at the block level, block resource centers, BRCs, have been created. at the cluster level to oversee, to manage, to supervise different activities in the schools. CRCs have been created. These CRCs refer to the cluster resource centers. And all the most important is the community participation, the parental participation in elementary education affairs. The main focus of the SSA and the elementary education sector is to engage community members in different activities related to elementary education. So this is the nature of management and governance in elementary education in the current scenario in our country. Now, the decentralized management structure, as you can see on the screen, at the national level, Ministry of Human Resource Development, which is the main agency responsible for education affairs, has established, has organized a national level mission to implement different schemes, different programs related to elementary education. Then, at the state level, there is a state level mission for elementary education for achieving the target of universal elementary education. And of this state level mission, there is the director of the elementary education of the state is the mission director. Then under that mission director, there is a special wing in the states that is known as state project office, headed by the state project director of SSA. So under this state project director or state project office, district project office, that is the DITES, have been established, which are headed by the district project director to oversee, to manage different activities at the district level. Then, to organize different activities related to elementary education at the block level in a smooth manner, block resource centers have been created. The responsibilities of block resource centers have been given to the BRCCs or BEOs. BRCCs refer to block resource center coordinators, or block elementary education officers were entrusted the responsibility of overseeing, managing different affairs of elementary education at the block level. Then under these BRCs, cluster resource centers have also been created to oversee and manage and supervise different activities related to elementary education. And under these BRCs and CRCs, elementary schools and school management committees function and perform their different activities. So this is the structure which you can see right from the national level to the school level. This is known as decentralized management structure, which is adopted in elementary education in our country. Now we will discuss about what are the major issues, what are the major challenges which are there in appropriate following up of this decentralized management structure in elementary education. As you can see on the screen, that what is the state of governance, what are the major issues of governance in elementary education? There are four major governance issues in elementary education. You can see on the screen, first, governance issues, they are related to students' admissions in elementary schools. Then the second issue of governance in elementary education is related to allocation and utilization of funds given to the elementary schools. How those funds are allocated, in what manner those funds are utilized, these are certain major issues. Then the other issue is related to governance of elementary education in our country, that's related to teachers' recruitment, teachers' promotions, and teachers' regularity in the schools. Teachers' recruitment, promotions, and regularity has also been considered a major issue and has also been under the scanner due to one or the other reasons. There may be political reasons or the other reasons. So these are the governance issues which are related to teachers' recruitment, promotions, and their absenteeism or regularity in the elementary schools. Then there are governance issues related to functioning of SMCs and schools itself. How the SMCs are functioning in the elementary schools. This also is a major governance issue in the field of elementary education. So learners, four governance issues, major governance issues are there. And now we are going to discuss about these four governance issues which are faced by the elementary education in our country, and as a result of these governance issues there are certain problems in the in achieving the target of universal elementary education. So one by one we are going to discuss about these issues. First, the governance issues related to students' admissions in elementary schools. As you can see on the screen, that the first governance issue related to students' admissions is that to ensure whether the student's right of entry into the school system is upheld or not. This means the student's right of getting admission under Right to Education Act 2009 is upheld, is secured or not. If it is not so, then the right to education is violated. The students are barred from getting admission, then that is the major governance issue, that whether the student's right of getting admission into a particular school is upheld or that particular student is barred from getting admission in a particular school. So we have to ensure this thing, that the students of right of entry to the school system must be upheld. Now, this governance issue of students' admission into the school system has further implications. That means whether the schools publish its admission policy or not. And this issue mainly deals with those schools which are functional under the private sector, or which are run by the NGOs, or which are run under PPP mode, public-private partnership mode. In such schools, whether the student's right of entry is upheld or not, it is to be seen by the authorities. Whether the students of right to admission is given to them or not, whether the schools are restricting the students from getting admission, whether the provision of right to education, that the 25% of the seats will be reserved for economically backward children, is that provision is followed or not. So it is the governance issue whether such schools publish its admission policy, how the students' admission admissions will be monitored, whether the school's final and annual report listing the number of applicants and admissions made in the school, how much number of applicants were there, how the admissions were made to the school, regarding this, whether the schools file an annual report or not. This is a governance issue which has to be seen, which has to be monitored by the authorities. And this is major issues coming in the schools which are either functioning in private sector or which are functioning in PPP mode. So these are the governance issues related to students' admissions. Other issues which are related to students' admissions are, how students are selected for admission, what are the admission criteria for entry of the students into the schools. This is a governance issue which has to be seen, which has to be monitored by the authorities. Then another governance issue related to students' admission is, what happens to those students who do not get their choice, who do not get the school of their choice? The system as a whole would need to ensure that all students are accepted to at least one school under reasonably equitable conditions. That means if we wish to achieve the target of equity, then we have to ensure that all the students must be accepted by at least one school, and they must be given admission at least by the one school of their choice. These equity related issues, if not addressed properly, may result in unequal educational opportunities. That means the students' admission right will not be upheld, will not be secured, will not be monitored properly by the authorities. It may give rise to the unequal educational opportunities, and these unequal opportunities, if there then will be a bottleneck in achieving the target of universal elementary education. So these are the major governance issues related to students' admission, how the students' admission process is followed by the schools, how the students are given admission, what are the criteria of giving admissions to the students at the elementary level. These are the governance issues that are acting as a bottleneck in achieving the target of universal elementary education in our country, and the authorities must have to see and monitor and take appropriate action to address these governance issues. Now, the governance issues related to allocation and utilization of funds in elementary schools. How the funds are allocated to the schools, how those funds are utilized by the schools. In this regard, you can see on the screen, for example, I have given here one fund flow chart, how the funds are allocated from the top level to the bottom level. This is an example from the state of Himachal Pradesh. The center's share for Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan is released by the government of India to the government of Himachal Pradesh. Similarly, the government, state government of Himachal Pradesh, releases its state share, and both the central share and the state share are then given to the concerned department, just like in Himachal Pradesh, it is the Department of Elementary Education, which oversees, which organizes, which manages, which governs different activities related to elementary education. So the funds received from the central government of India and the funds released by the state government of Himachal Pradesh are given to the Department of Elementary Education. Then the Department of Elementary Education further release the funds to different districts, to different deputy directors, and these deputy directors then release the funds to the block level, to the block elementary education officers. Then the funds received by the block elementary education officers are given to the schools, concerned schools, and school management committees can have a say in utilization of different funds which are received by the school. So this is how the funds are released from the top level to the bottom level to the school level. Now, how these funds, this is the allocation of funds, and now how these funds are utilized by the school authorities. This is one of the governance issues which is faced by elementary education sector. So now we are going to discuss about those issues which are related to allocation and utilization of funds in the elementary schools. So first issue in this regard is to ensure that the funding to the local bodies will be secured and safe. Whether the funds released by the higher authorities, by the state level authorities, to the lowest level authorities, grassroots level authorities, is secured and safe and will not be misused, it is to be ensured. If the funds released are utilized for the appropriate purpose or not, it is to be ensured. And for this, the check has to be maintained. This is one of the major governance issues related to funds. Then, how will central resources be allocated to various local bodies for effective utilization? How the resources from the central level be allocated to the local bodies? What will be the procedure adopted for that? Is that procedure transparent in nature? It is a governance issue. It is an issue of governance that needs to be monitored at appropriate time so that there should be no leakage of fund, no corruption at any level. Then another governance issue is related to what extent the local authorities, bodies are free to utilize those allocated funds. Whether the local authorities or the local bodies or the schools are free to utilize the allocated funds as per their own wish, or will there be some restrictions? If restrictions, what restrictions will be there? What type of restrictions will be there? What percentage of allocated funds can be utilized by the local bodies? And what percentage of utilization of funds they will have to seek the permission, approval from the higher authorities? So this issue needs to be addressed whether the local authorities will have the freedom to utilize the allocated funds in according to their wish or according to the requirements of the school, or will there be certain restrictions for all the schools, and will those restrictions be uniform to all, or it will be depending on the particular conditions of the those local authorities or local bodies or the schools where that school is located, what are the socio-economic conditions or what resources are already available with the school and what they require. Will there be any this variation in utilization of funds for different categories of schools, for different categories of local authorities? This issue also needs to be addressed. Then, if the local bodies are required to generate their own resources for school development, if the funds to the satisfactory extent are not given by the higher authorities, by the state authorities, then how the schools, how the local bodies will generate such resources? What will be those resources, sources from where this financial help will be sought? Will the own generated resources sufficient to run school affairs appropriately? This issue also needs attention from the authorities. Will the self-generated resources from different sources sufficient to run the schools, to run the different activities at school level in an appropriate manner? This issue has also need to be addressed properly. Then another issue of governance related to allocation of fund is, what will be the mechanism of overseeing and auditing the funds utilization by local authorities or by local bodies? If the funds have been utilized by the local bodies, what will be the audit mechanism? What will be the mechanism to oversee whether the funds have been utilized in a proper manner, or is there any misuse of those funds, not used properly for the activities for which those funds have been released by the higher authorities? So what mechanism will be adopted to see the funds utilization by the school management committees or the school authorities? So this issue also needs to be addressed, which is one of the major governance issue in the field of elementary education. So learners, these are the issues which are related to governance of funds, of allocation of funds, utilization of funds at the elementary education. Now, governance issues related to teachers' recruitment, promotion, and their regularity in elementary schools. We will discuss about such issues. First, to ensure that the recruitment of teachers in schools be made according to the norms. We have to ensure this thing, that the teachers' recruitment in elementary schools be made according to the norms. This has been witnessed in different parts of country. Then different cadres of teachers have been created by the states, and in order to remove the shortage of teachers, the teachers are recruited, appointed through the local bodies, whether the norms fixed by the statutory bodies like National Council for Teacher Education in case of teachers' recruitment, whether the norms given by NCTE are followed by the local bodies while recruiting teachers in the schools. This issue needs to be addressed. We cannot do this thing that for the purpose of removing shortage of teachers, the qualification, the prescribed qualification required to become a teacher as per the statutory body norms are kept aside. This cannot be done. So this issue needs to be addressed. Then second, you can see that issue of teachers recruitment by local bodies has always been a matter of great concern. The teachers without possessing the prerequisite qualifications are appointed by the local bodies, and there are different political interests or other interests as a result of which the quality of education has declined. So in order to address this issue, the higher authority must have to see what may be the best measures to remove such problems. Then to ensure that no single teacher school remain in existence in the country, we have to address this thing, that any single teacher school which is in existence at present must have to be abolished, and there must be at least two teachers in each primary school, out of which one must be a female teacher. So in order to do that, how to recruit those teachers, how to recruit female teachers in the primary school, this issue also needs to be addressed by the authorities. Then another issue which is plaguing our educational system, elementary education field, is related to issue of teacher absenteeism in the schools. In the remote and backward areas, we have witnessed that the teachers who are non-village resident, they remain absent from the schools. And as a result of their absenteeism, the studies of the students get suffered to the larger extent. And as a result of this, we are not able to achieve the target of universal elementary education, neither in quantitative terms nor in qualitative terms. So, teacher absenteeism issue has to be addressed urgently by the authorities. It has to be seen by the authorities that how the regularity among the teachers to attend the school, to take the classes, to continue the teaching learning process in a smooth manner, that can be ensured in the schools. This issue needs to be addressed. This, as you can see on the screen, that teacher absenteeism plagues our government school. Now, what can be the solution for this? This is not only on the part of the higher authorities to see that it has to be done by the higher authorities, how to remove this teacher absenteeism or how to promote teachers' regularity. It is to be seen also by the local community, the school management committees, how to ensure the regularity among the teachers so that the studies of the students could not get suffered. Now, other issues which are related to teachers' recruitment, that is issue of diversity in payments of salaries. In schools which are run under private sector, private management bodies, there is difference of salaries. Not only in private sector, but also in case of government teachers, different cadres of school teachers have been created by the states. One particular cadre is given one particular type of salary, the other cadre of teachers is given some other type of salary. So there is no uniformity in giving salary to the teachers. This issue of diversity in payments of the salary to the teachers also is a major governance issue that needs to be overseen by the authorities, that needs to be addressed by the authorities, so that this diversity in payments of salaries should be abolished. Then the issue of recruitment of women teachers as per the policy provisions. The policy provision has been made that 50% of the teachers in the elementary schools should be female teachers. Now this issue of recruiting female teachers, women teachers in the elementary school also needs to be addressed. Then another issue of untrained teachers in the schools is there. At present, if we go about the data, there are more than 10 lakh of teachers in the schools around the country who are untrained. How to provide them training? How to transform those untrained teachers in towards the trained teachers? This issue needs to be addressed. So these are the issues which are related to teachers' promotion, recruitment and absenteeism. Now, issues related to functioning of SMCs in elementary schools, whether the SMCs are constituted appropriately or not, it is an issue that needs to be addressed. Whether the appropriate representation to the parents is given in the SMCs or not. Then, whether the SMCs meetings are conducted at regular intervals or not. It has been witnessed that the SMC meetings are not conducted at regular intervals, and the parental involvement in such meetings is not up to the mark. So this issue also needs to be addressed. Then Another issue is of appropriate preparation of school development by the SMCs. Whether the school management committees are preparing the school development plan in a proper manner, whether the components of SDP are included in that, whether the available resources with the schools are given due place in that school development plan, this issue has to be checked, has to be addressed by the school authorities. Then there is issue of provision of orientation to SMC members and teachers. The issue of providing orientation to SMC members, the parents and teachers needs to be addressed, because until and unless their participation in the school affairs will not be there, the quality improvement in elementary education cannot be ensured at all. So this issue also needs to be addressed. Then issue of protection of child rights. Whether the scholarships, uniforms, textbooks are given to the students at proper time or not. Whether the distribution of these free ships is at the proper time to the right type of student, is it given or not? This needs to be addressed. The protection of child from the abuse, corporal punishment, dignity, maintaining his respect, maintaining his dignity, maintaining his freedom of expression, maintaining non-discrimination in the school, and providing him equal opportunities for getting quality education. These are the issues that has to be seen by the teachers, that has to be seen by the school head, that has to be seen by the local authorities. And these are the issues that needs to be addressed urgently if we wish to achieve the target of social justice, if we wish to achieve the target of equity, if we wish to achieve the target of equality of educational opportunity. Then issue of functioning of SMCs and schools in coordination with the other government departments for providing inclusive education. The school has to function in coordination with Department of Social Welfare, the tribal welfare. For enrollment of working children and poor students, there is a need to coordinate with the Panchayati Raj Department. Now, in order to bring these departments on a common platform, bring coordination among these departments, the major issue is how to do this thing, how to bring them in coordination, how to bring them on a common platform. This issue needs to be addressed. For protecting child from harassment, abuse, exploitation, and working closely with National Commission of Protection of Child Rights, State Commission on Protection of Child Rights, and Department of Women and Child Development, how to work with these departments, how the school will work with these departments in coordination with these departments. This is an issue that needs to be addressed, that needs to be seen by the authorities, by the schools. So these are the issues which are related to functioning of SMCs. So learners, today we discussed about the management and governance issues in elementary education. The major governance issues in elementary education are four. First, related to student admissions. Second, those governance issues related to allocation and utilization of funds in elementary schools. Then the governance issues related to teachers' recruitment, promotion, and their regularity in elementary schools. And lastly, we discussed about the governance issues which are related to functioning of SMCs in elementary schools and how the schools and SMCs function in coordination with other government departments, NGOs, to achieve the target of universal elementary education in our country. I hope that all you have learned and understood about these governance issues in elementary education. Thank you very much. Have a good day.